scale from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another sale. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah.
Well, Coach, as far as home field advantages go in the playoffs, there are few places tougher on a visiting team than this one. Sold out Empower Field at Mile High in Denver. Coming up, it's divisional round Saturday, and we've got an AFC battle on tap between the Houston Texans and the Denver Broncos. The first of four berths in the conference championships on the line here as divisional weekend in the NFL is underway.
That's it, baby.
Ezekiel Elliott, and they're able to get this one across the 35. A pickup of 11 and a Texans first down.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
Back to throw, Watson. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. His first catch of the divisional round goes for a first down. He had five catches last week in their wild card win.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. From the 50, it's Watson. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Bradley Chubb coming in hard there on the blitz, and he gets him 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down.
Check 99! Check 99!
Out of the gun, it's Elliott. 4 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have to contend with a third and 13.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. From the gun, here's Watson.
And he'll find Hall. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well.
First down, Houston.
So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 36. Here's Watson. And finding the tight end Hooper. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Now back to the ground with Elliott. And he'll be out of bounds, able to get it down to the 25 there. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. Now they'll run on the ground. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Six yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. Oh, the ball is out. Watson lost it. It's picked up by the Broncos. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
Thank goodness for heaters up here. And thank goodness I don't have to carry the football in this game. It's January. It's cold out there. Trying to clutch the football and absorb the hits. Not easily done.
Yeah, we saw a product of the elements right there. Lock and the Broncos going to come up 1st and 10 at their own 27. First carry of the game here for Royce Freeman. Freeman a first down and more. And he'll finally be taken down just shy of midfield. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
This is a little bit like baseball here. Strong up the middle. Both sides want to be that. In this case, the offense ended up winning the ultimate battle.
And those big runs between the tackles, that's a little deflating for a defense, isn't it?
It really is, because that's where your strength's supposed to be. You're supposed to be in a spot where they can't make that yardage there. You're supposed to send them outside. Not in this case.
Here's Locke to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And there they bring pressure from the inside, and they get home.
Yeah, hard to block everyone, isn't it? And on this play, someone did not get blocked. He's the one who got home.
After the sack, it's 2nd and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Here's Locke. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
They went with a dime look on defense. 2 extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down.
57
Mike. On 3rd and long, it's Locke. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. Oh, he almost picked it. Nearly a turnover there on their opening drive. That's a throw he'd like to have back. Now 4th down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, You'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
On fourth down, on is Logan Cook to punt. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And well done here. That one will kick out of bounds at about the 8-yard line. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complimentary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance. If they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
Now a first down throw, Watson. He's going to have the first down past the 20. And right around the 20, he'll head out of bounds. That's good for a Texan first down, a 12-yard pickup. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
First down carry by Elliott.
Got you, boy.
And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Him for a loss of five. He is so tough to handle on the blitz, and that's Exhibit A. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. To throw is Watson. He's got Hooper on the short connection. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down.
But when you hit him on the move like that, and he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam, oh boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. The Broncos going dime. Two extra defensive backs for third down.
Playing pass all the way.
Out of the gun, Watson. And he's got Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll be stopped short of the first down as they rally to tackle him at about the 28.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it. And then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. At their own 20-yard line.
Ready, ready. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
18 big yards on that one. And a Denver first. From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive.
On the team.
go.
Now it's Freeman. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Now Locke throwing on second down. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43.
Offensively, when you see cover two, the thought has to go through the quarterback's head. Drive the football when making throws. It's not just the deep guys covering. It's the guys underneath you have to be careful of. Drive your throw. Otherwise, you see what results? Interceptions.
Good starting field position for the Houston Texans here as they come up first and 10 at their own 43. Here's Watson. That one complete, Elliott. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A pickup of 11 and a Texans first down.
Nice little nifty play for him there. That's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down.
They'll run on first down. It's Elliott. It's a six-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four. We're scoreless after one.
That's the end of the first quarter.
Texans football to start quarter two as they've got it with a second and four coming up. The last run got six, now second and four. Watson now to throw. Steps away to his left. Now he'll pull it down. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of three, but now it's third down.
Now how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Houston. Ezekiel Elliott, 36 yards. As his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. Myers connects on the PAT. And it's now a 7-0 game. For the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Broncos take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Denver offense at the line, ready to go. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. They'll run with a former Tar Heel, T.J. Logan. That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, You got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game. But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works a defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
Ready? 2 minutes gone by, second quarter.
Hey, we got to get the stop here, D.
Get it.
To throw again on second down. Lock. He's got his big tight end, Fant. Two catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Block now to throw. He'll find Metcalf. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Block now after the pick on the last drive. 3 for 3 to start this drive. It's first and 10. On the carry, it's Logan. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. James Bradberry there to make the tackle.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Okay, just like that. Just like that.
To throw on second and 6. Lock. This will be caught just inside the 10. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. That catch good for 5. It's third down. This will be play number 7 on the drive. 3rd and 1 yard.
You got nothing.
Hey, Delta.
57 to Mike.
Lock to throw on 3rd and 1. It's caught. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well. Gotta say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on 3rd and less than 1 yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage, so they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run as they are now on the board here in the first half. Extra point tacked on by Lambeau. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And you combine a big leg with a mile-high air. There's the outcome. This will sail out of the end zone for a touchback. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive helmet.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3 and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
The last run got a couple here, 2nd and 8. Now Watson. And he will find his man on the outside. 23 yards the pickup there. Well, that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
Watson in the offense going to come up first and 10. And he's 8 for 8 now, throwing the ball to start the game. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He finds Hopkins complete. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. From the shotgun again to Elliott. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
The Texans on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. On third down, Elliott. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a 4th down.
When we talk about Luke Kuechly, you can't talk about his overall game without talking about his intelligence and how he controls the whole defense. He quarterbacks that defense, and at times will actually make checks, just like a quarterback would on offense to get them into the right defense. They definitely were on that play. How about that finish, holding that to a minimal gain?
Too long for a field goal, too short to punt. That in-between range, and they'll go for it on 4th down. They will indeed snap it to Watson. And that is going to be incomplete. The all-pro linebacker Luke Kuechly right there on the coverage, stride for stride. And even though they didn't get it, probably the right call. Too long for a field goal and just not a whole lot to gain from a punt there.
Yeah, you wouldn't have really netted very much yardage if you punted the ball, right? And the thing about a field goal, and you know this from so much experience, the longer the field goal, the lower it comes out off the kick, right? Which means it's got a better chance of being blocked. So you're taking a chance either way. I like.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off at the 39. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Dropped at the 23 after a pickup of about 4.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Elliott. It'll only be a gain of 1 yard, and it sets up a 3rd down and 4 now. It's a gain of 1 yard, and it's
Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. Remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. Watson. And he's got the completion to Hopkins. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. A 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Texans have taken the lead. Extra point up and through by Myers. And that makes the score 14-7. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. On first down, Logan. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here, up to the 34.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is, that's where the linebackers usually play. First level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position end up making the tackle. And oftentimes we call them a hybrid, combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
On second and 1, Lock. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 19 yards there on the catch and run. Block now. 7 of 10 here in this first half, and he's got a first and 10. Block now on first down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Lock gonna throw. And that gonna be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It's way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Throwing now is Locke. He completes this to Sutton. Oh, and the big play's going to get even bigger as penalty flags are down, and I believe they're going to get a face mask penalty tacked on. So now then, the penalty's got him set up with a first and goal. They'll run it here with Logan. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal.
Let's get that ball, D. Let's get that ball. Hey, high 7. 59.
They look to throw. It's Locke. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
When you got your backs in the shadow of your goal line, you've got to be physical in that situation because there's not a whole lot of space, not a lot of wild plays that can be run there.
That's put up or shut up time. Defensively, nice job just to make sure they didn't complete it on that play. Third down and goal now. This Houston defense not backing down. They'll look for one more stop.
Spike.
Locked now on third and goal. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Quadre Diggs. And a great return as they're finally able to take him down.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
A little under 30 seconds to go. We'll see how they play it here on first and 10. And they're just going to run it here up the middle. A fresh set of downs on a gain of 13 there for the Texans. Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Man, let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work, but when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen, your confidence rises, and he's running with terrific ability right now.
So first and 10 now from the 30. A shotgun snap for Watson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Timmy Jernigan. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him.
It's second down.
So it's on to halftime in this AFC divisional round matchup. As now we send you out to Orlando and hook back up with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Win or go home, that's the name of the game, and we're back underway with the second half of this AFC divisional round.
Let's go, boys! Let's go!
Denver offense at the line, ready to go. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Lock again here on second and 10. This is the tight end fan. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Denver has a first down on the 15-yard play.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
The interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Throwing on first down is Locke. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40.
Look at me. Score. Score.
This is Logan. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Broncos first down.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 49-yard line. Throw on the right side, complete to Harrison. So that one a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that can be the make or break difference on a play. This time he had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. He got caught for the penalty.
To throw it is Locke, and that's going to be incomplete.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well, and he didn't get that done on that play.
Throwing on second and long. Locke, that's caught over the middle by Fant.
So apparently some grabbing there in the middle of the O-line.
I've often wondered why that doesn't happen more often for guys that play center. Having to snap the ball and then trying to get your hands into the proper position, that's difficult to do. He got caught that time.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. On second down, here's Locke. He's got his tight end, Jake Butt. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
59 Mike. Check, 59. On third and long, it's Locke. Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a fourth pick of the game. And now fourth down. Here's Logan Cook now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. That one sails out of bounds. A side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies and that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football. They're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
Watson going to pull back the handoff and keep it himself. And that's Elliott, complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Give him 32 on the play.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. Just like that, out of danger and up past the 40 now for first and 10. They'll run on first down. Dobbins. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That's good for a Texan first down, a 12-yard pickup.
Pardon, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get him. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for them. Show them that you're supposed to get the football.
So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 47. Here's Watson. And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack back at the 47-yard line. Bradley Chubb able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack. To throw is Watson. Buying time to his left. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Deshaun Watson, so multi-dimensional, able to scramble for the first.
First down, Texans.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Some room to run now. That one 28 yards on the ground.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
Set,
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal.
You better be afraid of me.
Watch the air.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. An 8-yard touchdown run. And the Texans push further out in front. Myers connects on the PAT, and it's now 21-7. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Here's second and seven now from the 28.
Fight.
They fake the handoff. Now Locke. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Cortland Sutton was the man he was looking for. But now it's third down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open. And this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Throwing his lock on third down. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
First and 10 at the 46-yard
line. On first and 10, here's Locke. He's got his big tight end, Fant. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. A good pick up there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
At the 38-yard line.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Locke looks to throw it again. Got a man open, it's Sutton. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans 26. Now a play fake, and here's Locke. And his throw is going to be incomplete. He was looking to go back to Sutton there, and that'll bring up second down.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. On second down, it's Logan. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. Now after the holding call, here's second and 20.
They're running it.
Again, they'll throw with Locke. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Za'Darius Smith. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
No, now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Ready?
Throwing on third and long. Lock. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down.
Put a
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Here's the set. It's an 18. We own them. We own them.
And well. Looking to throw again on second down. Watson. And finding the tight end Hooper. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. That one a gain of 20 and a first down.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. From the gun, here's Watson. Got his man there, complete to Gallup. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and 9.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9. Watson going to pull back the handoff and keep it himself. Yeah, he'll find Hall. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
A nickel set defensively for the Broncos here on third down.
Watch out, watch out.
Elliott, and they'll get him down at about the 37, well short of the first. One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Give him 11 yards that time on the return, and the Broncos take over, first down and 10. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here?
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Ronald Darby. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. They'll try to run it in with Elliott. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL, and he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time, so make sure you get in shape.
They'll try again with Elliott. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
They come out here in the eye. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Here's Elliott, and he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. And a loss of 3 to bring up 4. Well, if this defense can hold them to a field goal here, what a win that would be.
Not just a win on the possession, but psychologically take over the ball game. But this started with first and goal, so they were in four down territory right from the beginning. I say you finish it off and go for the touchdown.
So with that, you figure this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from three scores down, but don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though?
The Broncos on to the field, ready to start their next drive. Now, last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. 70, call that a very strong gain of 24. Shotgun snap to Lock. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense that's well coordinated. The front and the back really in sync. The front putting on the pressure, the backside being ball hawks and picking passes off.
The throw once more on second and 10. Lock dancing to his left. He's going to take off with it. And give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice gain.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
The offense on third down tonight, 3 for 7 so far in this game. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. They run with Logan. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down. On play action, Lock.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. From the gun, it's Lock. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. Second down and goal. Lock. Escaping the pressure. Now Lock, he lost the football. It's out. And the Texans scoop it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Now that turnover might just about do it here. Fourth quarter, the lead that you've got, they can just run the football, run the clock.
You're exactly right. They played smart, couple of first downs, and this one should just about be over.
On first down, Dobbins. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
They'll keep it on the ground. Dobbins, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it will go as a one-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. The Texans on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is third and 11. They'll run it now out of the gun. And the tackle made at the 13. He is well short of the first. 7 yards on the carry there, but now they're staring at fourth down.
That was a good run, probably right on the edge of breaking into something really big. So the defensive guys right now are talking about, okay, what can we do to slow him down before he truly gets started?
Taking it about the 36. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And this offense will take over right at the midfield stripe with a first and 10. Good starting position for the Broncos here as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. Freeman. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And he's going to be close to a first down as the tackle is made at the Texans 42.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. On third down, Logan. A Bronco first down there, 12 yards on the play.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
Get it! Right back to him on first down. And after the good gain last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that'll make it second and 12. At the 32-yard line. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On second down now, it's Logan. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one good for 13 and a Denver first down. The running game fully in sync, 1-11 on that play.
And sometimes it comes from the offensive coordinator, understanding what he thinks the defense is going to do and dialing up the perfect play. Sometimes the quarterback, though, can look at the defense, realize he needs to change it to a run, and that gets it done in a big way as well.
And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Offensive line right now really freeing up the rushing lanes on this drive.
And we have to give them props. They've earned them. But these big runs that we're seeing, they don't result without everyone else being involved as well. Blocking on the perimeter has to take place downfield, too.
Back at the 5-yard line now, second and goal.
I got you. I got you.
And they have secured a spot in the conference championship. And now you can start to smell it at this point in the season, can't you?
You really can, because the focus has been one game at a time, not looking ahead. But when you get to the conference championship game and you know you're there, the Super Bowl does loom in the future.
This magic with the gang, we ball out, it can't get tragic. All we got, we gon' let you have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change my habits. What would you do if you were me and didn't have it? Look in the mirror, now I'm feeling like a savage. Tell my son I love him, for him I'ma make it happen. Now my dreams reality, not going back to. You say that you proud of me, I turn my back, you laugh. The same daylight lights, camera action. Living in a dream, now my music they be blasting. Step out, I'm a star, always in the latest fashion. action. Had to set the bar, try to catch me lacking. Bank account for my son, he won't have to struggle. You can see it in my eyes, all I do is hustle. They tried to knock me off my feet, I'm ready to rumble. Felt like I ain't ate in weeks, working off the muscle. Oh yeah, oh my, we ride for my brothers, no lie. All you